Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Element here, aka Levette. I'm here to do a tutorial for you today on how I make THC oil. Cannabis and THC is great for relieving pain. I used it throughout my life since basically I was about 16 to help me deal with pain and cope with some things that I went through being a sickle cell patient. I'm going to make this oil in two different mixtures. I'm going to do one that is a pure THC oil mixture, and then the other one I'm going to mix in two other essential oils that are really good at helping relieving pain. I'll go over those real quick here with you. The first one here is peppermint. Peppermint is a great painkiller, and it also helps reduce muscle spasms. And it also cleans the skin. So when you apply it topically, it'll help clean the skin. It's not too good to put on any open wounds, but still good in helping reduce pain. The other one that I'm going to be using is camphor. Camphor as an oil. It has a cooling sensation, and it's like a natural painkiller. As well, it is found in a lot of things that are over-the-counter topical analgesics, like Icy Hot. I think Tiger Balm as well has camphor in it. And the oil, or carrier oil, that we're going to be using is grapeseed oil. Grapeseed oil is great for the skin. It helps moisturize it. You can put it on acne. It'll help clear up acne. It also promotes hair growth, and it will also help tighten the skin and tighten the pores around the skin. It will also reduce scars and remove makeup, but it's also known to be cooked with. A lot of people put it on pastas. You can use it as a salad dressing. So it all around is a pretty good one. It also has a pretty high fat content. THC is fat soluble. It needs to have fat to be able to bind to your oil. So grapeseed oil, I like to use as that carrier oil when I prepare my oils. I'm going to show you what I'm using today. It's the Levo infuser. This is a great appliance to have. You're going to be making your own oils, the THC oil. You can put pretty much any herbs in there, and it comes with like an herb canister. And you just pack your herbs in there. It opens right up. This container here, it's kind of hot because I've been warming it up. So this container here is where you put all your oil in. This size is about 19 ounces or 561 milliliters. It's very easy to use. You just sort of set your temperature. You set your temperature, we'll go over that a little bit later. You set your timer, and during out the timer, it'll keep the oil at that temperature, and then once the timer is done, it'll let you know, and you hit the play button, or eject button, and all your oil just comes out right in the bottom. It's already strained, so you don't have to worry about straining it or getting your herb mixed in with the oil. That aside for now. Today I'll be trying to make a oil that is about 90% THC. I have pretty good club in my area. I live out here in Los Angeles, California, so clubs are pretty much everywhere. I was able to just pick up some shake. It's about 17% THC. And that's like per gram. So I'm gonna do the math on this real quick. At 17. So we're doing about 17% THC, and we're going to do 3 grams today. I measured it out already. It's easy. You just grab your scale, turn it on, and let it do its thing and zero out. Zero out. Put your measuring container on there. You hit tear to clear out, and you add your herbs. There we go. You have to trust me on that one. But works out. There we go. Works out, so it's about 3 grams there. Easy enough, right? Figuring out that 90% THC on our oil. So we had 3 grams of the herb, and it's at about 17% THC. 3 grams is equal to 3,000 milligrams. So 17% of 3,000, which you can do on a calculator. Very easy. Open up the iPhone here. Go to our calculator app. He said 3,000 milligrams of our herb, and we're going to multiply that by 0.17, or 17%. So that's 510 milligrams of THC in our herb here. So we have that notated. 510 milligrams of just straight THC. Okay. Next part here is, since I'm going to be pretty much using the entire canister on the level here, which I said was 19 ounces or about 561 ml, it's going to be a little bit stronger than 90%, but to get that figured out, you take your 510 and you put it over X. X is going to be the amount of milliliters you want your oil to be to get it to, we said 90%, so 90% is equal to 9 over 10. Okay? Very simple equation. You cross multiply. So 9x is equal to 5,100. Divide both sides by 9 so that we can get x alone. X equals Right back to our handy calculator. 5,100 divided by 9. 566. So x equals 566.6. So 566.6 is how many milliliters we would want to equal 90% THC on 3 grams of our herb. So, very simple, 566 ml. Like I said, 566 ml is a bit more than what our level here will fit in it. But let's go ahead and dive in, get started. Enough of the boring math stuff. Let's see how we did our strength calculations. So, go ahead and start with getting our canister. Power up the level. Got our canister. I'm just going to put the herb right in the canister. Simple enough, just all fits. Grab your lid, and throw your lid on there. Easy enough. This is a magnetic stripe, and it goes right inside here. There's two little lines that'll show you where to put your canister. And then this is another magnet that goes right inside the canister center, and you make sure it'll hold it in place. When you start adding your oil, you don't want it to move around while it's cooking in there, so that is all set. Next part is, we've got a beaker here, and we'll go ahead and get our carrier oil, the grapeseed oil. This is about a 500 ml beaker, so we're going to need a little bit more than what it has here. Canister here somewhere. Ah, there it is. Alright. So, got some more grapeseed oil. Make sure we get that up to 500 ml just like that. Set it down. So yeah, we just go ahead and begin pouring in our oil. close your lid. And under there for safe measure. And go ahead and set it up. THC breaks down at about 395 degrees Fahrenheit. When you want to infuse it into an oil, you really don't want to get to those temperatures. A good temperature to usually infuse around is right around 215 to 235 degrees Fahrenheit. This model of the Levo maxes out at 200 degrees Fahrenheit, so I'm going to go ahead and do it at 195 degrees over the course of 2 hours and 15 minutes. So you just increase your timer here. Set your temperature to what you want it. It increases by 5. So 195, 2 hours, 15 minutes. And then you hit play. And that's pretty much it. It'll start warming up. Once it starts getting to the temperature that it needs to be at, it will go ahead and start the infusion process and start counting down for you. So until then, I'm going to stop the video, come back later, and we'll finish it. So my Levo infuser just finished heating up. You can sort of hear it whirling there. You can see it starts to count down on the timer. It says infusing. Hey you guys. Alright, I'm back. And our Levo has completed its infusion process. It's nice and easy there. It says complete. And still a little bit warm here. But go ahead and hit eject. Back into our beaker. Let it go, seals back up. Sometimes it doesn't always seal back up, especially when you first start it. You kind of got to look out for because it's going to make a big mess all over the counter, as we saw earlier. Blooper, but oh, I did it out. Anyway, so this mixture here is our infused oil. Last bit of that out. And if you look at it, you can see it's very clean. Very clean. There's no real trace of the herb, but I walked it and you can smell it. The THC is very strong in this. I like the way this turned out. This is great. This is exactly what we wanted. So, go ahead and set that down a little bit. Now, with essential oils, you don't really want to add it while it's still too hot. Such oils will typically diffuse or break down at lower temperatures than THC will. So you may want to give it time to cool down a little bit first before adding any essential oils. I told him that I was going to make two mixtures, so this one, like it is good to go. You can put this on any pain spots and the THC will start to do its job and help alleviate some of that pain. I have here these dark vial bottles. I believe these ones are 1 ounce. These are really good to help keep out UV rays, so it'll help your oil last longer, won't break down. It's a good place to store it. Keep it that way. comes with level droppers, help with application. I'm going to do a couple of these. Funnel, very useful. Boom, like that. I find it easier to just grab a regular measuring cup. Measure out a decent amount, and that'll fit into the bottle. And just pour it right in. Thing to mark on it. No. Done with that. Alright. Now. For the sake of time, because it's getting late, and I'm getting tired, I'm going to head and show you the part of mixing the essential oil. This part is pretty easy. Essential oils, especially if you get the 100% pure ones, they are very effective in what they do, so you really don't want to have more than a 1% mixture in yours. What I'm doing this one here is about 4 ounces of oil will fit into that canister. If you do the math, let me grab my calculator. So, Google, also very handy to have. If you do a conversion, you can see that 4 ounces is about 118 milliliters. So, if you want to get 1% of 118, you multiply it by 0.01. And you get 1.18. So to make a mixture that's 1% camphor, 1% peppermint, in our 4-ounce jug here, we need to do 1.18 ml. So I know my droppers that I have here, these will typically measure out 1 ml. If you want to be on the safe side, get yourself a graduated cylinder. Markings for it. There's 1 ml all the way down the bottom. Actually, it's 2, and then there's no real marking for 1, but that first little mark there, that's going to be your 1 ml mark. A little bit
bit less than 1 ml. Just didn't pick up enough. So really you want to keep it seated, and then make sure that that line with the bubble of your essential oil or whatever liquid it is right on filament line. That'll get you a very accurate measurement. Make sure that your mixer's not too strong, especially if you have sensitive skin or you break out easily some things. Make sure that you have your correct measurements. Definitely helps. So, go ahead, open up a foreign bottle. Drop it there. Measured camphor. Pour that right on in. The peppermint oil that I showed you, I went ahead and put it in another jar as well. The one that it came with, the bigger one, does not really have a dropper, so I just went ahead and switched the bottle, labeled it. Cylinder. Yep. So we're right about 1 ml. Add a tiny bit more. Close that up. There. And once again, we've got our measuring cup, 4 ounces here. Halfway. There. Just give it a little bit of a shake. Done. Easy enough, right?
Now, I don't recommend doing this, but
I gave mine time to cool. I waited it for a while after Nova told me had it completed. So, let's go ahead. A little drop on the skin. A bit nice. Easy enough. Enjoy, you guys.